Greetings. Part 2. So imagine that millions of dead bodies are suddenly everywhere. Civil authority is going to have to do several things. There will be activities driven by health issues. You can't allow dead bodies to just sit there, gather flies, and spread disease. A government must gather and collect and dispose of all the dead bodies. It would be handy if a government had an agency designed just for such an emergency. Fortunately, the United States government has planned for the deaths of millions of Americans. FEMA has literally millions of multi-person coffins purchased, prepared, and waiting in storage for this event. Literally millions of coffins prepared and ready for millions of dead Americans. Is it possible they are simply being thorough and preparing for some undefined, unknown worst-case event? Perhaps they know of a super virus that will kill 20 million Americans like the Spanish flu. Perhaps they figure eventually Islam will use nuclear weapons against the U.S. mainland. Perhaps they know when they dictate the abolition of the U.S. Constitution, it will force a civil war. There seem to be many reasons why there might suddenly be 10 to 20 million dead bodies in America. Perhaps they think that the Christian rapture may need to be handled. Contingency planning of a state ready to control its entire population. Think about the possible effects of the rapture. First, there will be millions of dead bodies left behind by the Christians. For those remaining, there will be several responses. Panic, anger, torment, resignation, bitterness, and a release of complete lawlessness. What else do you think will happen when 10 or 20 million Americans all die at once? How long do you think it will take before someone identifies the group which is gone? In fact, many decades ago, the New Age movement already offered an explanation. You'll laugh because it is stupid, but it passes for wisdom in New Age circles. UFOs and alien abductions. Gaia cleansing herself. I'm sure the liberal news media will stridently repeat whatever the Obama administration offers. And if you are left behind and these videos still exist, do not lose hope. You've just begun the 7-year period of Earth history called the Tribulation. You will want to begin reading a Bible to have some idea what else is about to happen. But please do not read the Left Behind series. It is a Christian fantasy of a band of hearty adventurers jet-setting around the globe in an untrackable Gulfstream G5. And it is largely based on outdated and wrong eschatology about a revived Roman Empire, oblivious to Islam's identity as the one-world religion of the Antichrist. Forgive me if I have kicked over your sacred cow. They were decent works of fiction, but they should not be a basis for your end-time worldview. I honestly think you should be expecting the rapture to take place, and soon. But I want you to ponder the following concept. Maybe the rapture is the catalyst for the end time to begin. Again, imagine how America would be paralyzed by 20 million Christians raptured or dead. Imagine how the world would be paralyzed by hundreds of millions of Christians, raptured or dead. Dictatorial countries would have an easier time controlling the news and handling of the event. But would America continue to have a stable and smooth economic path? I think not. And if America was paralyzed emotionally and economically, what do you think the Muslim Arab world would suddenly feel free to do? Attack Israel. Is it possible the rapture is the trigger for the Gog and Magog war? The Gog and Magog invasion still needs to happen before the tribulation. And if you are left behind, don't blink. Signs in the heavens seem to indicate September 2017 is the middle of the tribulation. You do the math. And don't blink. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.